Hi everyone, it's Candace at Dr. Emmer's office, and I'm here with a patient who is just 5 days post CO2. He also had a bleph, so you can see little sutures here in his eyelids. He's gonna have those taken out on Friday, but we did this only 5 days ago. Dr. Emmer went pretty hard on the cheek area, especially as we were treating acne scars. So this is only 5 days out, which is pretty remarkable because he's pretty much done peeling. And the skin underneath is red, which is normal, which is desired. It means that we have collagen being produced. But we're doing a post-healing facial. We're doing oxygen, LED. We'll do a hydrating mask. So these types of facials come in handy after procedures like this because it really just helps to remove some of the dead skin and also hydrates the new fresh skin, helps reduce inflammation. So it's very, very beneficial for anyone that's had any sort of ablative laser. Even we do this after facelifts with lymphatic massage. So these types of facials are awesome for anybody that's doing more aggressive treatments for the skin. So right now we're just doing a gentle cleanse. He came in just now and he had his post-care products on, which include a thicker balm type product that helps to just keep the skin protected. So I'm removing all of that before we get started with the facial. And I'm just using a very gentle cleanser to remove all of the product. As you can see, he's a little bit swollen still, and that's okay, part of the healing process. But really what we're gonna do today is focus on hydrating the skin and allowing us to get deeper penetration with the use of the Echo Oxygen machine. Okay. All right, cool. It's really important after these types of procedures not to pick. It's really, really hard, I know, for a lot of people to not want to touch things or peel things because the face is basically full scabs. So hands off at all times during this, except for when you're applying your skincare products. It's important not to pick or peel anything, and this goes for regular peels as well, because then we're risking damaging and scarring that fresh new skin underneath. So we just want everything to naturally slough off. And that's why I'm being very gentle. Some skin will come off, but it's already dead that's ready to come, but I'm not encouraging skin to peel before it's ready. So we basically just gently pat. And you'll notice that some of the skin looks kind of green. It's not infected at all. It just basically is the color of some of the products. And since the skin is dead here that's coming off, it kind of sticks to it. But this is totally normal and it's such a great result. And it's pretty remarkable that we're only 5 days out. Traditionally, CO2s, people can be out for weeks. And Dr. Emmer has really kind of pinpointed the healing process and gotten, you know, an exact science down to what kind of products help to advance the healing. So our patients are really healed, you know, through that full scabbing within a week, which is really great. And then obviously your skin continues to heal over the weeks and months post CO2, but for the face to be pretty much done scabbing is really, really rare. And that's why we've come up with this post-healing regimen, and the facials help play a role in that as well. I'm just getting all the cleanser off.
How often do you recommend this after getting CO2?
We like patients to come in for a couple of them. So like I said, he's 5 days out. He's having one today, he's having one Friday. So he'll have two during his post-care. It just really helps. We see it advance the healing process, and it feels good for them. You know, the skin is tight. So having these treatments is, you know, it's beneficial for the overall outcome, but it makes their life feel better. You know, it makes the skin not so sensitive. So that looks good. I'm gonna use a bunch of different vitamins for the skin that will advance the healing and some liquid minerals. And I'm just gonna put this topically on the skin. If there's questions on the live, just shout them out.
Which products?
These are Echo products. So this is the device that we use. It's the oxygen machine that we use. And they make a whole line of healing vitamins. So I have some E, some C, a little bit of vitamin A, but it's not like a retinol where it'll peel you. I'm going to use a little bit of ProHeal Serum as well, which is a vitamin C with E.
Does this stain the skin?
No, this is all just very gentle. The vitamins are in like an almost oil base. They're pure vitamins, but they feel a little bit oily. So it's very calming and soothing. No stinging. And then I'm going to load up the oxygen, the nebulizer. All right, so for the nebulizer, we fill this up with an enzyme that helps to push the vitamins deeper into the skin. I'm literally just going to take drops of each of these and put in here. And oxygen is great for all skin types. It's good to add onto any facial. It just helps to push these vitamins deeper into the layers of the skin and get you super hydrated. So this is good for anybody that's doing something, you know, maybe a big event. This is ideal because it makes the skin glow. We do it a lot on people right before red carpets. In fact, tomorrow's the Latin Music Awards, so we have a lot of people coming in for these beforehand because it makes the skin just look really nice on the red carpet or before weddings or anything. But when we're doing post-healing, it just really helps to super hydrate, and as I mentioned, it makes the patient feel better because the skin is so tight. Let me plug this in. So this is a medical grade oxygen concentrator. The nebulizer, as I mentioned, this is where we put our product. And then we can mist the skin. And this is super relaxing, feels really good. And just allows for the skin to get nice and hydrated. So I'm gonna mist him for a few minutes. After this, I'm going to be applying a textile mask. It's actually, it's a fabric that's impregnated with placental stem cells from a cactus, I believe, or agave plant. So this is a healing mask that we'll use on him, and then we'll also do some LED. And the LED really helps to calm down the inflammation and redness. It also helps with pain if he's experiencing any pain, but by this point he's not. Day 5 isn't that bad. It's really the first couple days where you're, you know, not feeling too great because everything's really tight, but he's in the home stretch. So doing these types of treatments will just kind of advance the healing process. Although it does take a couple months, you know, it's not gonna be next week with no redness. He's gonna continue to be red for weeks and months after this. And as I mentioned before, the redness is really a sign of collagen production, which is needed for the healing of acne scars because we're lifting the scars out with that collagen production. So he can anticipate redness for months after, and that's why doing these facials and continuing on a treatment plan is really important. When we do Fraxels or microneedlings or other types of lasers that create that injury, we're piggybacking off of the results from CO2. So it's all cumulative. Everything that we do just, you know, gradually helps the healing process. So I'm gonna wrap up with his oxygen. We'll do his mask, we'll do his LED, and that's the post-healing facial. All right guys, thanks for watching.